How to process a comet in DeepSkyStacker. That's coming up next.
That is super dumb.
Hello, my name is Doug Hubble and welcome to Astrophotography Tutorials. Today we'll be talking about how to process a comet in DeepSkyStacker. Processing a comet's a little much different from your normal processing steps in DeepSkyStacker. So stick around and I'll show you the steps on how to do that.
Well, this is DeepSkyStacker and I captured Comet ISON this morning and I wanted to show you how to process it. This is something I've never done before, is process a comet in DeepSkyStacker. But the way you do this is you just click on one of your images. And by the way, you get these images, of course, you open them up in the picture files first. But once you click on one of these images, it'll pull it up in front of you, and then there's this little comet, edit comet mode, little green star there. So you just click on that, and the first thing you have to do is you have to register the frame so you know where the comet is. So we'll do this, so we'll say check that box and say to register all the light frames, so it will register every single one of them. After it gets done registering all of the frames, say okay, it'll go through and do that. I'll give it a score here at the bottom. After it gets a score down at the bottom, then we can start marking where the comet is. I'll show you how that's done next. If you go in and you look at it, you can actually see there's the comet right there, but it's not really processed very well. So what we need to do next is we have to tell it that there's a comet in the frame, and the way you do that is you have to get back to the file list here, and you click on the first one. It loads it up. And when you see it here, it's kind of dark, so what I do is I take these little sliders up here, I guess, for the brightness on it, and just kind of move that in a little bit so you can see it. Now it shows up, and I'm just using the scroll on the mouse, the scroll wheel, to get to it. But this is the comet right there, and what you have to do is you have to set the comet the center of it. Now you see right here, it sees that bright star and thinks, oh, that's the comet, let's go ahead and do that. But it's not, it's actually this right here. So the way you do that is you have to hold the shift key down, and when you hold the shift key down, then this little click to set the comet here will move anywhere you want. So you get right over top of the center of the comet, then left click it, puts a little round circle around it, and then what you do is you save it. And once you save it, you'll notice down here that it changes the stars to plus C, meaning that it has a comet in there. And in order for you to stack the comet, you have to go through each and every light frame and do this over and over. I'll just do one more, show you how that's done, and then I'll do the rest and come back in just a second. It's loading it up right now. Okay, now that it's loaded up, it tries to bring it in there. I'm gonna go ahead and zoom in on it. You'll notice that the comet is actually moving. It's no longer centered there. So you select this little the comet mode right there. Hold the shift key down and center the nucleus of the comet right there, and click it again. And you noticed it moved a little bit. So now we got the center of the comet in that one. Click the save. Well, before I do that, let's go over here so you can see it. I'll click the save, and you'll see that now I've done two. There's two plus C's in there. Like I say, you do this for every single one, and then you come back and stack it. I'll be right back after I mark them all as comets. After you've marked all of your frames with a comet and it has a plus C on it, you next check all your frames, and this is where you may not see this special comet tab. If you click register check pictures like you do most of the time, and you go to the stacking parameters, you don't see a comet tab. And the only way the comet tab actually appears is when you go to stack check pictures. So we click on there and then go to stacking parameters, and then you see this elusive comet tab. Now there's three different types of comet stacking that you can choose from. The way I processed my comet is I chose the one with the comet stacking method right here, and it gave me the trailing stars on there, but I got a better result out of the comet. And then I did a second one where I did the comets and the stars together to make the stars come out, and then I used a Photoshop layer mask to bring everything together. So it's up to you how you decide you want to stack your comet. Play around with these different settings and stack it, and once you select one of these settings, you just say okay. And if you want to change anything in here, you can do that with the recommended settings tab. You can go inside here and it'll give you some suggestions. You just can select either one of these and just say okay. Once you do that, you just okay again, and then it goes through its steps and it'll stack the image for you.
If this is your first time watching, I would like you to subscribe. I publish 2 astrophotography videos on the 1st and 15th of every month. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon.